What's going on, guys? My name is Mark Wagner, and today we're going to be talking about the strategies that I use in order to go from making like a couple $1,000 a day in revenue with Facebook ads to doing well in excess of $10,000 a day. Now, full disclosure, I'm talking about $10,000 because that's what I did for like about a solid week over Black Friday and Cyber Monday, and now I'm doing like $6,000 to $8,000 a day with really, really good profit margins, and I'm using the exact same strategies that I was before. So this kind of goes to show you that these strategies can be applied at any level. As long as you're doing like around $500 a day, then I'm confident that you can use this to, you know, hit 1,000 or 2,000 or 10,000. So it's really up to you, but like I said, you kind of do have to be doing at least a little bit so that you're able to use these kind of like scaling strategies. So let's go ahead and hop right into the value. All right, so as you can see, these two screenshots are literally a month apart. Now, granted, this is Cyber Monday, but still, like, it's a pretty big increase. And like I said, that's mainly from applying these strategies. So the first one is your creatives. Now, there's a reason why this is first, because your creatives are just like so super important. And I have realized this more and more as I've started to kind of like scale to the next level. Creatives are what is going to allow you to do that without that much difficulty. Really, if you have a good ad, you can do anything with Facebook ads. So I utilized a lot of story ads over Black Friday and Cyber Monday, and I still am utilizing a lot of story ads. Now, I've talked about this before, but story ads are so underutilized, which means that they have pretty low CPMs. Now, I only do Instagram story ads, but you know, it's definitely worth testing like Messenger and Facebook stories as well. But basically, like, it's super easy. You just gotta find a good story ad, which basically just means you test a bunch of story ads and see which one works best. And then you take your best like current campaigns that are in the feed, and you just duplicate it and change the placement to story, and then replace it with your good story ad. And 99% of the time, it's profitable. And a large portion of the time, it's more profitable than your feed ads. Another really big thing that's gonna help your creatives and just allow you to scale to that next level is just mixing up your creatives, because when you are spending like thousands of dollars a day, then your audience is gonna get tired of seeing your ad pretty quickly. So it's really important to just kind of like switch it up on them, and you don't necessarily have to create an entire like new ad to do this. You could just change what's called your scroll stopper, which is like the first 5 seconds of your video. It's definitely worth testing like tons of these, because that can like reignite a creative and allow you to scale to levels that you have never been able to before. And then in addition, I kind of like to switch up my thumbnails as well. Even though this isn't super important with Instagram, it's pretty important with Facebook. So like I said earlier, having a great creative makes the scaling process fairly easy. And if you can't scale past like a certain amount like profitably, then it's probably your creative that is not allowing you to do that. I really try to test new creatives at least every 2 weeks. And I'm not talking like a new scroll stop or whatever. I'm talking like at least 5 completely new videos. And maybe I'm just like mixing up like the order of my current videos as far as like clips go. But at the same time, they're still like completely new videos. So that's probably the reason why you aren't able to scale to a certain amount, or your product is too niche. Like, I had a product like this before. It never really got above like 4 or 5 grand a day. And I think it was just because it had a very, not like a tiny market, but it had a pretty specific niche market. And that obviously gets saturated pretty quickly. And creatives are definitely going to help with that. They definitely help me scale from like 2 to 4 or 5K. But at the same time, there's only so much good creatives can do if it's a really small market. All right, so the next thing we're going to be talking about is expanding your audience. Now, obviously, this is very, very important, especially if you want to be spending like thousands and thousands of dollars a day. So I have a couple different strategies for this. And the first one is a pretty underutilized strategy. I don't really know anyone else that does this, but I basically take my top interests. Like let's say, I don't know, jewelry was working really well for me. And then I would test interest expansion, which is like a little box that you can click below that interest, which expands it to like a certain amount of people depending on the countries that you have. I think it's like 46 million for the big five, something like that. But anyway, it's just going to give you a set like 46 million that are like the people in that interest. And then I'll make an additional ad set that I also use interest expansion with, but I'll narrow it by engaged shoppers. So it ends up being like, I don't know, like 7 million or something like that. I honestly can't really remember off the top of my head, but testing just these two different, you know, variations of an interest has had some incredible results for me. And it's funny, some of these actually work a lot better than the actual interest. So I generally do this for any ad set or any interest that has above like 5 sales with like above a 2.5 ROAS or something like that. I mean, it varies depending on the product because obviously my break-even ROAS is different. But I just have like certain rules where if it falls into that category, I'll just go ahead and duplicate it twice. Then do what I just talked about. And like a large portion of the time, it ends up working out very, very well. And obviously with a bigger audience, you're going to be able to scale higher because you have more people to sell to. And your audience isn't going to be used to seeing that advertisement. So it's obviously going to work a lot better. So generally, when you launch a product, you're going to find that a pretty specific target market buys it the most. Now, granted, there's some products that like works really well with 18 through 65, but for me, I generally tend to see that most products work really well when I launch them in like a 5 to 10 year age range. And then obviously like a specific gender. I'm only launching products with a big five. And I generally tend to see that like only Instagram feed or Facebook feed does best. Now, some products I do auto placements, but generally, like I said, Instagram or Facebook feed is what I narrow it down to. Now, this is all fine and dandy for when you're like launching a product and like, you know, testing interests and stuff like that. But when you actually want to scale it, Facebook is probably already going to know who your buyer is. So you can actually expand your age. You can go to worldwide targeting and you can do like auto placements or maybe like add in Instagram if you are on Facebook or vice versa. But basically, this is just going to make your audience way, way, way bigger, especially with worldwide targeting. And this isn't necessarily a good thing to do if you're first starting out, just because I found that like it just overloads Facebook with people. But once they already know who's buying your products, giving them more options to pick from is really, really going to improve your results. All right, so the last way that you can expand your audience is by remaking your lookalike audiences every now and then. Because if you think about it, if you're doing like, I don't know, a 180-day window of all of your customers, and then you get 10,000 purchases since you've last made that lookalike audience, it's not going to update with those 10,000 purchases. Now, you can do one of two things. You can A, make another lookalike audience for another 180-day window, or you could do, okay, well, let's just do a lookalike audience for the past 14 days. And then Facebook is going to have a completely, well, not a completely, but a very, very different group of people based on those like 14 days versus like, you know, 180, just because it's obviously different people who bought your stuff. So this generally tends to work decently well for me, but I've found that with lower like time frames, like, you know, 14, 30, 60 days, it just doesn't work as well as 180 days for me. However, it is definitely worth testing. And if you do have like a large amount of data, then I definitely recommend that you either try like remaking it for, you know, 180-day frame, or for like a smaller time frame. All right, so now we're going to be talking about the scaling structure that I use to take my store from, you know, $3,000 a day or whatever it said to like 16. Now, I don't scale with ad set budgets. I know a lot of people do, but I mainly just use CBOs because those generally tend to work a lot better for me and they work for a longer like time frame. Because with ad set budgets, like sometimes I can scale it up and get some like decent profitability going, and then they'll just die like the next day. And that doesn't really happen with a CBO. Kind of takes time to get up there. Not always, but it kind of takes time to get up and it takes time to go down, which is actually really, really good because I would rather make like a $200 a day profit for like 5 days than make like $500 a day profit in 1 day, you know, if that makes sense. So yeah, again, I don't scale with ad set budgets. I just use CBOs and I'm normally doing about 6 ad sets in each campaign. But I've also found that 10 ad sets does work pretty well. But again, like 90% of my CBOs run with 6 ad sets. Now I put 4 to 5 different creatives in each of my ad sets. And that's because I have 4 to 5 really, really good creatives. And obviously when you're doing like $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, $6,000 a day in ad spend, you know, your audiences are going to see your creatives a lot more. So it's very important to like kind of mix it up on them and give Facebook different options to deliver the best creative to the person that's going to perceive it the best. Now, as far as budget goes, I'm generally doing about $20 to $25 a day per ad set. Like for 6 ad set CBOs, I'm probably going to start out at around like $150 or like, you know, $120, whatever. And then during Black Friday and Cyber Monday, I was scaling these CBOs like super, super aggressively. Like if they were at $150 budget doing really well, then maybe I would just like double that. You know, the same day that it launches. Now, I don't do this anymore. That's just something you can get away with during Black Friday because there's so many buyers out there. But what I do now is scaling the CBO. I generally increase the budget by about 30% every like 5 days. But at this point, it's almost like, I mean, if you're only going from like 150 to like, I don't know, 200 or something like that, it's almost not even worth it. So I tend to do more like horizontal scaling than vertical scaling. Like, I mean, again, during Black Friday, I had CBOs going to like $800, $900 a day. But right now, I don't think I have any over like 250 or something like that. But I have like, you know, tens of CBOs. And that's just what's worked best for me. Like, I know a lot of people say that, you know, you have all this overlap. And I mean, that's fine, whatever works for you. But horizontal scaling and having like tons of CBOs with 6 ad sets each has just brought some really good results for me. So another way that you can scale some of your top audiences is to put them in like lifetime budget campaigns. So I basically, I don't do this that much anymore. And if I do, then it's like a longer duration one. But during Black Friday, I was doing like, I don't know, I would give it like 4 days to spend like $300 to $500. And those tended to work like really, really well. However, I tried someone like $1,000 a day, like stuff like that, not $1,000 a day, like $1,000 in like 5 days and stuff like that. It just didn't really work that well. So again, if you spend like $100 a day on a lifetime budget, it generally tends to get you some really, really good results. And what I found is if you do like 20 days, something like that, and you give it like $1,000 to spend or something, it's going to be consistently profitable for the entire time, essentially. So those don't really die out as much as ad set budgets do, in my opinion, but that's probably only because I'm using like my top audiences. Like I wouldn't just test an ad set with that, like, you know, $1,000 budget or whatever. So if you don't know what a lifetime budget is, it's basically where you just like, you give Facebook a schedule to run your ad at, and then you just give it a budget, and it's essentially just going to spend that budget where it sees fit. Like one day it may spend $2 and one day it may spend like $200. And this does tend to get you some pretty good results, but really it's just another way that you can diversify your ad spend. All right, so getting onto the subject of ad set budgets, because I do use these, I basically just have like a massive testing campaign. There's like, 1,000 ad sets in one of my testing campaigns right now. And I'm essentially just doing $8 a day budgets. And I test one single interest or like one lookalike audience. I've tested like all my lookalike audiences for certain products. And I've also tested like hundreds and hundreds of interests. And basically this just allows me to easily tell which one is working best so that I can go ahead and put it in a scaling campaign or in a lifetime budget campaign. But generally I only do lifetime budgets for like super, super proven ad sets, which they probably wouldn't be after spending like, I don't know, $40 in a testing campaign. All right, so let's get into the extra stuff. Now, right now, like I said, I'm doing like 6 to 8K and I probably have like, I don't know, like 25% of that coming from like old CBOs that I have duplicated and just changed up the ads for. Now, during Black Friday, Cyber Monday, obviously I had some CBOs that did very, very well for me, but they kind of died out like, I don't know, early December, mid-December, something like that. So I literally just like, I tested a bunch of creatives like 2 weeks ago or something, found a bunch that worked, and then I'm slowly duplicating basically all of my super, super profitable Black Friday, Cyber Monday campaigns, switching up the creatives, dropping the budget a little bit, and just relaunching it. And I'm getting some really, really good results. So if you like scaled during Black Friday and Cyber Monday, then I'll recommend that you follow that strategy as well. And keep in mind that this applies for like story ads too. Because like I said, I had some story CBOs that did very, very well for me. So you can literally just like duplicate a campaign twice, switch up the creatives for your feed, and switch up your creatives for your story. And you're probably gonna be left with two super profitable CBOs. Another thing that's worked really, really well for me is making a custom audience for 10-second video views. Because this is a really, really big audience for me. Like I think I did 180 day, and then I also have ones that are like 30 day and stuff like that. But yeah, it essentially just takes people that like already know your product and just didn't buy it. And it shows them either a different ad or even the same ad. And those tend to work very, very, very well. All right, so another thing that I kind of learned from scaling to this very, new point for me is that retargeting is like so super, super important. I mean, I was spending like $300 a day on retargeting at one point, if not more. And basically I structure it like this. I have one campaign for my warm audience and I have one campaign for my hot audience. And my warm audience is people that kind of know the product, like they're interested, but they haven't actually like gone to my website. And then my hot audience is people that have gone to my website and they've like viewed the product or added it to their cart or whatever. And then for my warm audience, the exact like custom audiences that I'm using are Instagram and Facebook engagement and 95% video view, and then sometimes 75% video view, but not always. And then I'm essentially doing all these on a 10-day time frame, with like purchases excluded, obviously. Now, for hot, like I said, it's just view content and then add to cart. But I kind of like structure the creatives in each of these campaigns differently. Like for the warm, I'm not just gonna throw them like a 20% discount and like really, really sell them on something because they're already interested. I'm essentially just going to like, you know, tempt them, I guess, with that product. Like I'm gonna show it in a really good way. I'm gonna phrase the ad copy so that I know they were like interested in it. And they're probably gonna buy it from me. And if they don't, then they'll likely visit the website and then they'll get in my hot campaign. My hot campaign is where I do give them discounts and I do kind of try to like push them to that next level. Like I really implement scarcity hard here. I do like a 20% off discount. And I'm really just trying to get them to buy it because I know that they're interested. I know that they probably want to buy it. Maybe the price was too high or maybe they just got distracted, whatever. Either way or not, like I'm going to probably get them to buy it from me with the hot retargeting campaign. All right, so another thing that I tested that worked extremely well for me was a last call retargeting campaign. And that's basically where I say this is your last chance to get X product at X percentage off because our Cyber Monday sale closes at midnight. And then I do a 30% off discount, which like is pretty significant. Some of you may not be able to do that depending on your margins, but was totally worth it for me. And this was definitely like, I'm still running these. I'm running this for like New Year's right now. And I'm going to continue to run this for every single sale that I have, because it was basically the most profitable campaign I've ever ran. Like crazy, crazy, crazy results. So I definitely recommend that you implement this. Really just whenever you have a sale. I don't care if it's like a very, very small and significant sale. Try a 30% off discount or a very significant discount and really just like, you know, give people one last chance to buy your stuff. All right, so the last thing that I learned at this scale was that rules are super, super important. Now, a rule is basically just something that you set in Facebook to get it to do a certain thing when something else does a certain thing. And I know that that's like a not good definition, but rules can be used for basically everything, which is really, really nice. And what I was using them for was to kill my ad sets once they hit like a certain amount of cost per purchase. Because you obviously don't want your ad set to be running for a long time if it's not profitable. And when you are spending a lot of money and you don't want to like keep constantly looking at your ads and like refreshing ads manager and stuff like that, then rules are your friend, because it's basically like someone who's doing that for you. It's watching over your ads, and if they hit like a certain amount of non-profitability, then you can just go ahead and kill them. All right, so the last thing that I want to say is that there's really no secret to scaling into five figures a day. Like, I didn't really think it was unobtainable, but I didn't really think it was like possible at this point for me. And it definitely is. Like, not only that, it really wasn't as hard as I thought it would. And I'm just disappointed that I didn't do more. Like, I really went ahead like 40K. In a day, and I know that I could have, but I just didn't end up doing that. But anyway, it's really just about having a good product with really, really good creatives, and then testing a ton, like test a ton of creatives, test a ton of audiences, just like find out what works and then run with it. Like, don't be afraid to scale hard once you have something that works, because if you don't, someone else is, and they're gonna take your money. So unless you want people to take your money, don't be afraid to spend a lot of money, as long as you know that you're probably gonna get a very good return on that. All right, guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and I really hope that it helped you in getting to that next level, wherever that may be for you. If you guys have any questions or any videos that you would like to see me make, then feel free to drop them in the comments below. You guys have an awesome day, and I'll see you in the next one.